والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today we're going to be looking at a very important topic, something that all of us were in need of, something that all of us we wish to do and we have to do. And that topic is a topic of ad-du'a, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month of Ramadan. Ramadan is not the only month for supplication. We can supplicate to Allah at any time besides Ramadan. However, this month of Ramadan and this act of worship which you do in Ramadan, which is fasting, has certain virtues attached to it. And one of these virtues is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts dua. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, one of the dua that is not rejected is the fasting, the dua of the fasting person while he's breaking his fast. Another thing that makes this month of Ramadan an opportune moment for making dua, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that in this month of Ramadan, most of us are up at dawn, in the last third of the night. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about this last third of the night in a hadith, he said, your Lord descends to the lower heavens in the last third of the night. And he asks, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks, is there anybody asking so I may give him? Is there anybody seeking forgiveness so I may forgive him? Another thing that makes this month of Ramadan an opportune moment for dua and forgive us and Allah's forgiveness is that at the dawn, one of the qualities of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ta'ala says about them, وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. In the dawn, the believers are always seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another thing that makes this month of Ramadan an opportune moment for calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that in it is Laylatul Qadr, the night of decree. And this night is so special, especially for a dua. So this month of Ramadan is a month of dua, invoking and calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this month of Ramadan is a month for us to heed the command of Allah ta'ala when He tells us that your Lord has said, call upon me. And Allah ta'ala did not only order us to call upon Him, Allah ta'ala promised us even better than that. He said, Astajib lakum, I shall answer your prayers. Look at the mercy of Allah ta'ala. Allah ta'ala ordered us to call upon Him, and He promises us to answer our prayer. Allah Ta'ala told the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if my servants ask of me, what should you tell them, Ya Muhammad? Allah Ta'ala told him, tell them, Inni Qareeb, I'm close to them. I answer the prayer of whoever calls upon me. So let them respond to me and believe in me, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala in a hadith, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala becomes angry if people do not ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So this month of Ramadan is a month for us to invoke and call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because while we're fasting this month of Ramadan, Allah ta'ala accepts our dua. In the dawn, we're up to ask Allah ta'ala's forgiveness. In the third of the night, is an opportune moment for us to ask Allah ta'ala for whatever we want. And more than that, in the night of Laylatul Qadr, if Allah ta'ala gives the opportunity to get this night, is an opportune moment for us to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this month of Ramadan is a month of dua. And that's why you find, even in the salah which you pray in the mosque of Tarawih, that the imam, he stands up in the last part of it, and he makes qunut. He raises his hand and asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah ta'ala answers dua in this month, because this month is a blessed month. And that's why if you look at the history, the events that took place in this month of Ramadan, you find the events in this place, in this time of Ramadan, were blessed events. And inshallah ta'ala, in the next episode, we'll be speaking about these events that took place in the blessed month of Ramadan. Till then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.